Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're doing all fine. Let's have a look on the Bitcoin price after this volatile weekend that we had. And if you were watching my yesterday's live stream on Twitch, we had here a nice trading range between 10,800 and 11,500, and it looks like that Bitcoin is starting to trade sideways here. And now we're going to analyze what is the potential next target, or what is the expectation for the next couple of days. And also we're going to have a quick look on Ethereum as well, because there maybe we're going to see what is coming up next. So here in the 1 hour, you can see that currently on the Bitcoin price, we have a potential breakthrough from the 20 moving average in the 1 hour time frame. After yesterday's a big drop here towards $10,500, the bulls were strong enough to bring the price again above 11,000. And now we also discussed yesterday that most likely we're going to stay in this trading range with a resistance of $11,500. And we have to see if this breakout from the weekend here from $11,500 up to 12,000 was valid or not. Because as you know, on the weekend, we always have play time. So essentially everything that we have done on the weekend is now vanished, because we're still back here at around $11,200. And we have to see if we're able to break here the resistance of around $11,500 or not. And currently we also have a new CME gap formed here up to $11,600. So we have to see if we are able to go and close this gap immediately, or are we falling the cliff here, breaking down from this potential rising wedge here to the downside. And in that case, the target would be at around 10,500, where currently we have a lot of support. And in theory, it should hold also for the next couple of days as a support. In case that we're going to lose here 10,500, then be prepared to retest and close also the gap at around 10K to $9,600. So more or less towards 9,500, I'm expecting a potential drop also to close the CME gap and then bounce immediately back up. But of course, it's possible that first we're going up again to retest 10,500, and there we're going to have to see if we are able to break through, or are we getting rejected there? Because in that case, we would also close here the CME gap that we created now during this weekend. And as you can see also here on the CME chart, we are perfectly respecting here the support at around 11,380 here. And it looks like that we could gear up here for another move to the upside with a potential target of $11,800 here on the CMEs. And we still are waiting here for a potential breakout. We had already here a wick to the downside here a couple of hours before. So we have to see if this is going to end up in a potential big bull flag, or is it a rising wedge that is a very bearish pattern. And then we could see a potential correction down towards 10K to $9,600, where the CME is lining up down here. Because in that case, we would also have the confirmation that the old resistance, this yellow line, is the new support here at around $9,900. We didn't test this new support yet, so it is possible that first we're going down to test it and then have the big bounce to the upside and also break $12,000. Currently, we're still trading here below the 20 moving average in the 1 hour. It's giving us resistance. It looks like that we could have a breakthrough here, also because the last 2 hours we had a nice wick here to the upside. So this indicates that the bulls are trying to fight the resistance here. And in that case, we should see a breakout here towards $11,500. The thing is also that on Ethereum, you can see we are forming a very nice ascending triangle that should break out also here to the upside, and the target would be more or less where we topped out on the weekend here at around $420. So let's see if we are seeing this potential breakout here to the upside. I'm pretty confident that here we're going to break out to the upside, and most likely also Bitcoin then could have a potential breakthrough here and a retest of $11,500. We are in a very critical point here on Bitcoin, because in the 1 hour, the RSI is right at the 50. So we are testing right now the midline. If you're able to bring the RSI again above the 50, then we should be good to go to the upside. And also stochastic currently is overbought. So we have to see if we're able to push through here, or are we getting rejected at this point? And we're going to again bring the RSI into oversold condition, cool off the stochastic before we can break out here. But also, as you can see, the 200 moving average in the 1 hour now is right at 10,960. So it is still within our trading range here between 10,800 up to 11,500. So if you're looking to open a long or a short over on the Bybit, BTR, or Femex, for example, then make sure to look at those price levels. And we can also have a look in the Bollinger Band in the 1 hour, because you can see that we're squeezing in this tiny channel. Currently, the top is at 11,260 and the bottom down here at 11,060. MACD is still shifted to the upside. So in theory, we should have here pretty soon a breakout to the upside, in my opinion. Also overshoot the Bollinger Band to the upside. We are trading in the upper area. MACD is bullish. So all in all, it looks like that the bulls are gearing up for potential breakthrough here towards 11,500. But if we are able to break it with the first time, I'm not pretty sure at this moment, but it is, of course, possible. And what we also have to see is here in the 4 hour, what will happen with the 4 hour candle, because currently we're still trading below the 20 moving average, which is a bearish sign. Also RSI here, same like in the 1 hour, is right at the 50 level. We have also here the stochastic oversold. So in theory, we should see a potential breakthrough and then hopefully also start to create a support above the 20 moving average in 4 hour. This could indicate that we will most likely fight here the $11,500 and potentially also break through. But currently here in the 4 hour, we are still bearish. Most likely we're going to stay in this channel here between the 50 moving average here at $11,000 and the 20 at $11,260. So watch out for the 4 hour close here if you want to enter a trade. And remember, my friends, currently we have this trading competition going on. So we have registration right now and the competition will start at the 10th of August. If you want to participate, then make sure that you tune in here on Bybit. If you need an account, then sign up with the link that you find down below here in the video description. You will get $90 sign up bonus if you fulfill all the requirements, like so put some deposit or follow them on Twitter and so on. They do a lot of giveaways, so make sure also to join Bybit. And if you want also the trading competition, if you want to sign up to my team, also the invitation link is down below here in the video description. And also if you have some Tether left on the sideline like me, then you can, of course, also trade all the coins that you want with Tether just using Bityard as an exchange, because here you can trade all coins that you want with your Tether. So you can also gain some Tether here and then buy Bitcoin or any altcoin that you want. This is how I'm doing here. And on Bityard, you have a lot of promotions, a lot of welcome boni. You can get up to $258 plus extra $50 in Tether if you put at least a deposit of 0.5 Bitcoin into it. And the last bonus that you get here, you will get it in cash. So this bonus here, you can also withdraw immediately or start to trade with it. And you need only 1 million in trading volume. That is not really a lot compared to the leverage that you can use. So if you always use like high leverage, then you will get it very, very quickly. And the next two BTR, I'm also recommend you Femex. So if you want to trade also on Femex, it's a very nice platform where you can trade different altcoins as well, like a Link, and also you can trade gold here. So with your Bitcoin, you can also trade gold, for example, here. And if you need to buy instantly some cryptos, also on Femex, you can just use your credit card and you can buy immediately, for example, Chainlink, Ripple, Ethereum, Tether, Bitcoin, whatever you want, just using your credit card. So if you see the price dropping or you see the perfect buy opportunity through Femex, for example, or also through Bybit, also they offer this credit card thing where you can buy very easily and instant. Sometimes they even give you some bonus if you use credit card. And yeah, with that, you will not miss out in the next buy opportunity. So make sure that you have an account over in Femex, Bybit and Bityard. The sign up links are down below here in the video description. And with my links, you support the channel and also get some sign up bonus. On Femex currently, it's I think a bit more than $72 if you register today. And now we can go back to the chart and open up also the Bollinger Band in the 4 hour time frame, because here you can see that in the 4 hour we're still trading on the bearish side. So we still have a target here of 11,400 down to 10,870. MACD shifted to the downside. So here the 4 hour is still looking a bit bearish. We have to see what will happen and if we can break through here through the 20 moving average in 1 hour. We have to see if we can build up support above the 20 moving average in 4 hours. So keep that in eye in case that you're entering a trade. And also there we're going to see if we're able to break through $11,500 or not. And now let's switch over into the daily. because here we are very close now to the 20 daily moving average at $10,400. It is very important that even if we have a drop here to the downside, that we're not going to close daily candles below the 20 moving average. That could indicate that we're going to see a major correction, potentially even down to the 200 daily at 8,750. I don't think that we will go that low. So even if we have a major crash, I think here this yellow bottom line here from this channel that we were in here since now many weeks should hold as a very strong support here at around $9,300. So this is, in my opinion, the worst case scenario in case that we're going to get rejected up here. And you can also see that the stochastic now shifted to the downside after being very overbought. RSI, same thing. So also here we could expect a potential cool off down to the 50 level in the RSI and potentially test here the 20 daily moving average at $10,400. And this is where I think we could see a potential test here of this $9,800 support, this red line that previously acted as a resistance and now should be acting as a support. And there maybe we're going to also see a week or two down to 9,600 to fill the CME gap that we have there. And now let's have a look in the Bollinger Band in the daily, because here we're finally retracing back here into the Bollinger Band after overshooting it now for several days. We have the MACD that could look toppy here. In case that we start to trade sideways here, it wouldn't be too bad. But if we're going to have here a bearish cross on the MACD, this could indicate that we're going to test here the middle line of $10,000, potentially even start to trade here in the lower area for a very short-lived amount of time. Because I think even if we could see 10K again, this will be very short-lived. And I think the bulls will immediately buy up this potential correction that is still in the cards. But of course, it is also possible that Bitcoin is currently gearing up for the next big move to the upside. So it's not guaranteed that we will have this correction, but it's still in the cards right now. And now we can open up the weekly time frame, because here we close now the week. Yesterday we had this nice green candle. It is possible that we could see a potential test here of this new support down here. But in my opinion, it is still looking like continuation here. And although the 20 weekly moving average right now is here at 9,310, where exactly our support is lining up of this channel. So that's why I'm telling you, if we're going to have a major drop, this is potentially the last time we're going to see Bitcoin at those price levels so low. And sub 10K. RSI and stochastic are now coming very close to overbought conditions. So we have to see if we're going to have a correction or not here. In my opinion, it is very likely that we're going to have a correction, but Bitcoin, if it's starting to go parabolic, you cannot stop it, and all these indicators will go crazy, so you cannot just trust on them. If Bitcoin decides to break here 12K and start to test 14, 16, 20K, no one can stop it. And we can also have a look on the Bollinger Band in the weekly, because currently you can see that we are also here trading right at the top of the Bollinger Band. It is very, very likely that also here we can cool off here a bit before we continue here to push through. Last week we had an overshoot here, and this ended up in a week to the upside. MACD is also still shifted to the upside. So the weekly is looking very bullish, even though it could be a bit toppy here. So the trading range, in my opinion, it's still here between 11,560, maybe even down towards 9K. And that's why be very careful if you're taking a long or high leveraged trade right now. Also, you have seen this weekend what can happen. Darth Vader is back, so these kind of corrections you should expect at any time. That's why always when you're trading, use stop losses or always put a trade just before liquidation price, because like this you cannot get liquidated, and I don't want you to get some liquidation emails from the exchange. That is the worst email that you can have when you wake up in the morning. And also a little side note, my friends, at the end of the video, I have always my outro, and now I'm gonna use the music from my friend Caspro. So shout out to him. And if you want and you like the song, you find the link to the song always at the bottom of the video description. If you click there, you will be forwarded to his song, and you're very free to leave also there a comment and tell that Alessandro the Crypto have sent you. That would be very much appreciated. He makes some really great music. So if you like it, then make sure to also subscribe to his channel and like his music as well. And with that said, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up for now. Make sure to tune in here every day. We're gonna also do the subscription video for our $10 worth of Bitcoin giveaway later today. And also make sure to subscribe on Twitch if you have Twitch, and you're very welcome to join our free Discord trading chat. The chat is completely for free. Everyone is welcome. We have a great community over there. So shout out to all the people in Discord. And also, of course, if you need any kind of trading account or you want to claim some free coins over on Coinbase, if you use Coinbase, you find some free slots to get some free Coinbase earn coins like Orchid, EOS, BAT token, XLM, and so on, all down below here in the video description. So thank you very much for watching, my friends, and we're gonna see us all in the next one. Bye.